Hello, it's me again, and welcome to my presentation of the Ghost of Marilyn. If you have photosensitivity or any sort of health issues or are easily frightened, please discontinue this video and consult a medical and psychological professional, and do not watch The Ghost of Marilyn. I want to give a shout out to one of the best friends I ever had. His name was Paul Reed, from back in 19 and early 90 something, late 80 something, at Dover Mills in Pisgah, Alabama, my little hometown, where he taught me about color and the way light affects color. So shout out to Paul. Godspeed to you and heal fast, and I can't wait to see you in 1,000 years at that great party. Anyway, we're going to talk with the Ghost of Marilyn tonight. I think I need to see if I can get down my cobweb duster friend here and see if he'll help me remove a few cobwebs from the Ghost of Marilyn. Would you do that for me, little cobweb friend? I think we're having like a earthy shakes here. Yes, I'll do that for you, Uncle Goat. I'll get some of those cobwebs off of the Ghost of Marilyn for you. Oh, I got the one on reverse. Side of your eye. I don't know how you'll feel about that one. We'll find out when you come through to us tonight. Ooh. Tell them bye-bye, cobweb. Bye-bye, y'all. See you later. Enjoy the Ghost of Marilyn's cobwebless bust boobs. Jolly Roll Ranchers, bye bye now.
You are so beautiful to me. Can't you see? You're everything I ever hoped for. You're everything I need. You are so beautiful to me.
Now what I want y'all to do is get in a quiet place, make sure you ain't driving, and make sure you ain't sensitive to photosensitivity stuff, and just be peaceful and be alone. It'd be great if you can be in the great outdoors under the stars and everything, and put Marilyn off just at a sight distance to where you can can really look her right square in the eye. She's right between the eyes. I know she's a little cockeyed there, but I always liked her that way. Anyway, just get out there with Marilyn and look at her. And I'm gonna change the lighting, and you just keep staring right at Marilyn. And then every once in a while, look off into the dark, up into the sky. Look at the moon and see if you can't see Marilyn's face in the moon. And I'm gonna zoom out a little bit after I do these effects. This is gonna be quite a long video because I'm getting some of my NFTs together and stuff like that. So we're going to go to a strobe effect next. Slowly. Just stare right into the ghost of Marilyn and I'll be quiet for a while and let you meditate. Now just keep staring Marilyn in the eyes and watch her. She changes to more than one woman. Her body moves in different, her eyes move. She's watching you back.
There she is.
Can you hear her? No, not auditorily, not with your ears, but with your inner self. Reach out. Who do you see? Is there anyone you would like to see? Anyone you know or don't know? Where are they? Is their energy close? I wished I could read lips. Hey, if there's any AI watching this out there, what do you think about this? Tell me below in the comments. I think they should let AI start commenting on our videos. Well, thanks for coming to the guided meditation of the Ghost of Maryland. And we will say goodbye. And someone leave in the comments for me the credits for the person that created the original photo that I used as the backdrop for my photo. And if any of you would like to stay around for my dismantling the display, I may talk a little bit. Don't know where I'll post this. I guess I'll post it on Facebook because YouTube's being dumbasses about Little Bob and Little Lucy. When they was little, they done some firework videos, and they are going through and giving me community strikes for smoke bombs and things that we just used to do naturally in the South. And they learned most of that from YouTube. I think there needs to be somebody do something about that. But we're going to turn on some lights here and see if we can wake Marilyn up. There you go, girl. Zoom out a little bit here. We'll only zoom to where. Oh, I got a mess in the background there. Forgot to clean off the refrigerator. Let's see if we can zoom that in just on Maryland and the hourglass. I have together except for my dirty shirt hanging on the chair back there. But anyway, I painted this with, I don't remember where all I got the colors. I mixed acrylics with oils and some of Little Lucy's fingernail polish, and Little Bob had made up some potions out of flowers, and I used chicken feathers out of the yard and painted the ghost of Marilyn, and we done some of that dust from the bioluminescent dust on it, and that's what she done. And I just talked to Marilyn a lot while I was painting her, and then every time I hang her on the wall, I've never been able to capture it on video very well, because I've had people run screaming out of my house just because they sit there and Marilyn starts coming off of the painting, and her hair will grow real long and curly and beautiful like Farrah Fawcett's used to be, and then it'll grow up into a bob. Like, I mean, she just transforms. She's every woman in the world to me. My mama liked Marilyn. I like Marilyn. So, I guess that's all I've got to say tonight. Bye-bye now. I'll see if, I'm gonna have to just start my own website, because YouTube's being a dumbass. What about we start something and call it NewTube? Little Bob coined it back on the, old video where it says, Little Bob Rides Flame, I believe it was. Bye-bye now. And have I said that already? Uncle Bud used to say I'm a chronic lingerer, and I chronically continue talking. So I must be a chronic lingerer.